We had every single fighter in the world. The best fighters today that are fighting today were all my fighters. And that certain person I'm talking about, Al Haymon. You know, he's a very, very interesting character in the sport of boxing. Look, every single fighter I had, like Deontay Wilder and Crawford, you know, fighters like
Crawford, Terrence Bud Crawford. When'd you have him?
Look, every single fighter I had, like Deontay Wilder and Crawford, you know, fighters like Spence, all those guys, you know, they're all world champions now. And so what we're doing now is rebuilding our stable. Like the Virgil Ortizes of the world, like Zurdo and Jaime Munguia, Ryan Garcia, Jojo Diaz. So
what up, Fight World? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Oscar De La Hoya, he wants me to believe that Al Haymon is the problem, but he doesn't even know his own stable. That's what I'm going to talk about in this video. What up, Fight World? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. You heard the clip. Oscar De La Hoya did an interview with Ariel Helwani, the MMA Hour. I'll put the link in the description. Now, De La Hoya, he sounds like Al Bundy to me. Love and marriage. It's an institute you can't disparage. This. He sounded like Al Bundy talking about the game-winning field goal that he kicked at Polk High in the 70s. He's talking about Al Haymon and then saying he wants to make Tank Davis an Al Haymon-advised fighter versus Ryan Garcia. This is cap. He's talking about Al Haymon, but it was him who threw up this last minute obstacle when Jermall Charlo and Jaime Munguia were trying to fight. I mean, it's not looking good. It's not looking good for the boy De La Hoya. You want to blame Al Haymon for your shortcomings. And again, to me, Oscar, I do believe he's throwing it all on Al Haymon, but we may get Terrence Crawford free agent versus Errol Spence, an Al Haymon advised fighter. And that's a fight a lot of y'all been hitting me up about, undisputed. And meanwhile, Golden Boy's stable keeps dwindling. Like, if you listen to all the names, he said, we're currently rebuilding. Listen to all the names he said. They were all Latino fighters. You don't have a diverse stable. You said Ryan Garcia, Jojo Diaz, Zurdo. That's not a diverse state. Where are the Ukrainians? Where are the black fighters? Where are the, you know, Caucasian fighter? Like, it's crazy. And again, Oscar, he's claiming credit for Terrence Crawford, and he was never under the banner. But without further ado, let me so I could finish cooking this story up for y'all got to hear the rest. Roll the clip.
I've worked with Bob Arum. I've worked with Don King in the past. I've worked with every single promoter out there in the world, and I have no problem whatsoever. I have no ego whatsoever. I just want to make these big fights happen. And you know, that certain person, Al Haymon, who basically controls everything, all the fighters out there at PBC. I just want to make these big fights happen. And you know, that certain person, Al Haymon, who basically controls everything, all the fighters out there at PBC. It's a tough position to be in, but you know, as long as we keep on beating that drum, hopefully he'll crack.
How do you feel about the current state of Gold?
Hopefully he'll crack, but PBC, they're making their own fights. Now, Oscar's done several interviews, and he's making it sound like PBC's not having a hard time putting together fights that people are interested. For example, Jermall Charlo versus Castano, much needed, undisputed. Errol Spence and Crawford, not announced, not official, but it looks like they're making progress. Gervonta Davis versus Rolando Romero, 18,000 people showed up in New York. So to me, this just looks like all cap from Oscar De La Hoya and Golden Boy. And again, he reminds me of Al Bundy. Like, you're still holding a grudge, but then you want to make a fight. It's just all over the place. You want to make a fight with Al Haymon, but then you're also downing Al Haymon and saying, you know, he's not trying to make a fight. But he's worked with you for Gary Russell and Jojo Diaz fight, right? He sent fighters like Danny Jacobs over to DAZN, Andy Ruiz over to DAZN to fight against Anthony Joshua twice, right? This is not a mystery. And Oscar, he should know better because he sued. Golden Boy sued. He's not talking about the emails either, which is another, what they called Al Heyman in the emails. Look it up. It starts with the N-word. You know what I mean? But outside of that, him not addressing those things, he already tried suing Al Heyman and his case was dismissed. So I just don't see how this gets you closer to your said goal of Ryan Garcia. More BS in boxing where it's a blame game.
Boy, are you happy with where the company is at?
I'm extremely happy where it's at. Obviously, we were, when I started Golden Boy Promotions, I built it, and we had every single fighter in the world. The best fighters today that are fighting today were all my fighters. And that certain person I'm talking about, Al Heyman.
Like, bro, the question Ariel asked was, are you happy with where Golden Boy is? Why are you talking about the past with PBC and Al Heyman? Like, just listen to the question and listen to the answer.
We had every single Golden Boy Promotions where it's at. Hopefully he'll crack.
How do you feel about the current state of Golden Boy? Are you happy with where the company is at?
How do you feel about the current state of Golden Boy? How are you talking about Al Heyman? Just listen. It sounds crazy.
I'm extremely happy where it's at. Obviously, we were, when I started Golden Boy Promotions, I built it, and we had every single fighter in the world, the best fighters today that are fighting.
We had. He sounds extremely salty, yo.
Fighting today were all my fighters, and that certain person.
They were my fighters. Why didn't they stay with you? They had an option. They're humans. They had choice. Why didn't they stay with you? Why did Abner Mattes, Amir Khan, Danny Garcia, Errol Spence, Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder, oh my God, from Tuscaloosa to this day. Why did he leave? Why did Errol Spence and all these other Adrian Brown, man, you know, AB, African babies, at the end of the day, why did these guys leave? See, there's something that De La Hoya is leaving out. He's like, oh, I started and I built these guys, like he always says. Why did Charlo leave? Why did Jermell and Jermall Charlo get bigger after they left you? You know, actually, one Charlo, you wouldn't even sign. Jermell, I was in Vegas, and he told me that, like, at a media scrum. He said he wanted to get his brother Jermall Charlo signed, and Golden Boy kept saying they were going to give him Canelo and kept saying, you know, this and that and sign his brother, and then they didn't do it. So it's just looking like cap.
The best fighters today that are fighting today were all my fighters. And that certain person I'm talking about, Al Heyman. You know, he's a very, very interesting character in the sport of boxing. Look, every single fighter I had, like Deontay Wilder and Crawford.
When did De La Hoya have Crawford? What are we talking about? Crawford wasn't even a PBC fighter. He's been with Top Rank for a decade, probably 11 years, to be honest.
Every single fighter I had, like Deontay Wilder and Crawford, you know, fighters like Spence, all those guys, you know, they're all world champions now. And so what we're doing now is rebuilding our state.
They're world champions now. Errol Spence got bigger after he was no longer working with Golden Boy, right? I'm pretty sure the Kell Brook fight was after Golden Boy days because he fought him in Sheffield.
So basically, realistically, I mean, fight with the chocolate Ryan Brownie, right?
So what is De La Hoya even referring to? And it's like he's flabbergasted and he's reliving the past of fighters that all left you. Why did they leave you? Why did Leo Santa Cruz and them leave?
Like the Virgil Ortizes of the world, like Zurdo and Jaime Munguia, Ryan Garcia, Jojo Diaz. So little by little, this is what we do best, is build the very best fighters out there. So we're on.
He's saying we build the best, but all those fighters from PBC got bigger after they left you. Broner fought Pacquiao after he left you. That's one of the biggest names he's ever fought. He fought Mikey Garcia after he left you. Leo Santa Cruz and Tank Davis, you know, Leo Santa Cruz, that happened after, well after Golden Boy was no longer working. So he's saying he's extremely happy, but De La Hoya sounds extremely sad and salty. And that's just my personal opinion. And he wants me to believe that, you know, like as if Al Heyman stole his fighters and stuff. Why didn't they stay? Canelo's the only one that stayed. And then he ended up leaving you. So to me, Golden Boy is in a tough spot. And it sounds like, you know, he's just like, it's like an old drug dealer or something from the 90s. in 2022, and he's talking about how, man, in 94 we all had Audis and Beamer Benz and Bentleys, Beamer Benz and Bentleys, and you talking about all the stuff you had, and then you got locked up, your people went down or got shot up or whatever happened, and you no longer have those things, and you're just, you know, revering the days that are long gone. That's what it sounds like here. But why would I believe that Al Haymon is a problem and De La Hoya doesn't even know his own stable, and he's saying he had Terrence Crawford when he clearly didn't have Crawford's career? And now Crawford's a free agent. He's probably going to work with PBC, hopefully, to get the Errol Spence fight done. Checkmate. And I'm out. Subscribe. Introducing Super Thanks. Right here on the official Boxing Ego YouTube, Super Thanks allows you, the viewers, to show a little bit of extra gratitude, which enables me as a full-time content creator to push out the content you need in the world of boxing. Underneath all the videos, you will see a heart with the dollar sign in it. You can enter any amount that you find suitable as a Super Thanks. A brand new interactive and colorful way to get your comments highlighted and noticed by not only myself, but other people on the YouTube platform. Super Thanks, a unique and cool way to show and applaud us full-time content creators. Hopefully you guys enjoy the content. Super Thanks. The future is now. The Hibernation 5s by Kenichi Bear. Hybrid gaming and lifestyle headphones. Out of the box, you can connect to any console or PC. Bluetooth ready with a low latency USB adapter, color RGB, and extreme bass mode. The Hibernation 5s adjust to you. Whether you need a gaming, travel, gym, or lifestyle headphones, the Hibernation's got you covered. The new Hibernation 5s, link in the description. Customize the way you hear the world. Welcome to the nation. Are you tired of your YouTube videos not getting any views? Well, consider TubeBuddy. I've used TubeBuddy for years to scale up my YouTube channel. Now we're sitting over 200,000 subscribers. TubeBuddy is a browser extension that offers a ton of built-in productivity and time-saving services to take your channel to the next level. Use my link in the description to get started with TubeBuddy and level up your channel faster. We work.